Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. So we're recounting the pastimes of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, which is described in a book by Sanatana Goswami called the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. So Gop Kumar is giving instruction to a Brahmana from Mathura about how he made use of a mantra to travel to all the places throughout the material and spiritual world.
上节课就讲到了，高帕库马他正在教导马图拉的一位。It's
unstable, Guru Mani. So sometimes you may hear me, yes. Sometimes you may not.
So, okay. So we're, I understand, Maharaj.
So we're hearing. Gop Kumar was giving his association to that Brahmana from Mathura, and by that association, the Mathura Brahmana became very inspired in devotional service. So we're going through a purport, a very long purport given by Sanatana Goswami about the value of association.
Sanatana Goswami 就写了一段很长的要旨, 就讲述了联谊的重要性。
And so one of the quotations which he's given in the commentary is a quote given by Prahlad Maharaj about the importance of association. Here's one verse which is from the seventh canto where Prahlad Maharaj said, we have to get the dust from the lotus feet of the devotee who has no material attachment, who has no material desires. So, before Prahlad said this, he had described his concern for the ignorant, materialistic people. They cannot understand the importance of self-realization. So their only hope is to somehow bathe in the dust of the pure devotees.
纯粹奉献者的莲花足下的尘土当中沐浴。
They have to find the association of people who have no interest in anything else but devotional service.
他们必须努力地去找到这样一个人的联谊，这样这个人呢，他除了奉爱服务之外，他没有别的欲望，没有别的兴趣了。
Without the mercy of these great devotees, these materialists will never be able to understand the importance of bhakti yoga.
没有这样一位伟大奉献者的仁慈，这些物质主义者他们无法明白奉爱瑜伽的重要。
They will never understand it theoretically even.What to speak of the actual facts of it.
他们甚至在理论上都无法明白，更何况明白这个实际的事实呢？
Then there's another statement given here by King Muchukunda.
接下来是一段Muchukunda 王的话。
Right. Muchukunda is described in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam in the pastimes of Krishna that he had been a great king, a great kshatriya, and he'd been fighting on behalf of the demigods for a long time, and he was very tired.
在圣典薄伽瓦他第十篇当中描述 Krishna 消时光的时候提到了这位伟大的国王穆楚昆的，他是一位查彻亚，他因为跟帮助半神跟恶魔作战，所以他非常疲累。
So the demigods gave him a benediction that he could sleep for as long as he wanted.
半神们随后就祝福他，他可以睡眠的时间是想睡多久睡多久。
And they told him that if somebody wakes you up.Then when you open your eyes, fire will come out from your eyes and you'll burn them to ashes.
他们告诉这位国王说，倘若有人把你给吵醒的话，那么你只要一睁眼，从你的眼中就会冒出火焰，把这个人烧成灰烬。
So it happened one time Krishna was fighting with another king. When Krishna was still living in Mathura, he had to fight against Jarasandha.And then one time he had to fight against Jarasandha was another king, a rival king who hated Krishna, and he fought with Krishna. And then another time this other person came, Kalanimi, and he came with a big army, and he also wanted to fight Krishna.
有一次主 Krishna 就和一个名叫 Jarasandha 的国王就展开了激战，那后就第二次呢，他这个 Jarasandha 王就特别憎恨 Krishna， 还有另外一次又有另外一个名字叫 Kalanimi 的大恶魔率军队来和 Krishna 展开战斗。
So Krishna led this demon up the mountain.And then Krishna went into the cave. The demon was chasing Krishna, and Krishna just went up the mountain. So the demon came after Krishna climbing the mountain, and then Krishna went into a cave, and the demon went into a cave also. And in that cave, Muchukunda was laying sleeping.
So Krishna 就引领着这位恶魔就朝山顶的方向跑去，这个国王呢，恶魔国王就在后面紧追不舍，就一直追到山顶。这 Krishna 呢，就爬到山顶的一个洞穴当中，穆楚昆的王就在这个洞穴当中在那里睡觉。
So when when the demon saw that Muchukunda laying sleeping there, he thought that Muchukunda was Krishna, and he kicked him.And so Muchukunda woke up, and from his eyes fire came out, and the demon burned to ashes.
这位恶魔国王就一直尾随着 Krishna 追到了山洞里，他看见山洞里正在睡觉的那个国王，以为是 Krishna， 就一脚踢了那个睡觉的那个人，这穆楚昆的就被恶魔给踢醒了，他一睁眼。 从他的眼中立刻冒出一团烈火，把这个恶魔，把他踢他的恶魔就烧成了灰烬了。
So Krishna knew, of course, this demon was there, and Krishna arranged all of this.
主 Krishna 他一清二楚，就这个就恶，他知道这个国王在那里睡觉，也知道这个恶魔，所以他就精心的安排了这一切。
So Krishna came and met with Muchikunda, and Muchikunda offered prayers to Lord Krishna.
主 Krishna 就又过来来会见 Muchikunda 王。Muchikunda 王一见到主 Krishna， 立刻献上祈祷。
And he told Lord Krishna, he said, when the material life of a person comes to an end, then he may get the association of Krishna's devotees.
Muchikunda 王向 Krishna 祈祷说，当一个人的物质生活达到了终点之后，他就可以得到主 Krishna 奉献者的联谊。
And then with the association of devotees, then he awakens devotion to Krishna, and the goal of the devotees, he awakens devotion to Krishna, and Krishna, of course, is the goal of devotional service, to know Krishna.
倘若一个人能得到主 Krishna 奉献者的联谊，他就能够唤醒对主 Krishna 内心的奉爱，那么奉献服务就是人生的目标所在。
So only after they're fed up with material life are they allowed to come in touch with devotees.
只有当一个人对物质生活已经厌倦透顶的时候，他就能够接触到奉献者了。
One has to be tired of the material world, and then we can take proper advantage of the association of devotees.
一个人必须对物质世界已经彻底的厌倦，之后呢，他就可以充分的完全利用奉献者的联谊。
So by the association of devotees, some people become fortunate and they get free from birth and death.
通过奉献者的联谊，一个人就会鸿运当头，他就能摆脱生死轮回了。
And some who are even more fortunate, they may develop love for the Supreme Lord.
然而更加幸运的是一个人甚至发展出对 Krishna 的奉爱。
And if they're not fortunate enough to get love for the Supreme Lord, at least they have to learn how to serve the Lord.
倘若一个人还不够幸运得到对至尊主的爱，至少他应该学习怎样去服务至尊主。
Some people,like most of us, you know, we're not so qualified to develop Krishna Prem, but at least we can become Krishna Das.
比如说，就像我们没有那么，我们没有资格发展出 Krishna Prem 的 Krishna 爱，但是至少我们应该成为 Krishna Das, Krishna 的仆人。
So Krishna says the same thing in the 11th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. He describes, he said, just as cold and fear and darkness are removed when one approaches the heat of a fire. So, maybe you translate that.
Oh, okay. So, 就在圣典薄伽瓦坛第十一篇有这样一句声明，正如当一个人接近火的热量的时候，自然而然的，他的寒冷、他的恐惧，还有四周的黑暗都消失殆尽。
So in the same way, our fear, our dullness, and our fear and our ignorance are destroyed when we engage in serving the devotees.
同样的方式，当我们能够服务一位奉献者的时候，那我们的迟钝、恐惧和愚昧也都被移除了，也被消除了。
Devotees of the Lord, when we are fixed in absolute knowledge, then we are peaceful.
当我们处在稳处在。绝对的知识当中的时候，内心就会平和。
And we can give shelter to the people who are suffering in the material life.
这样我们就能给予那些在物质生活当中饱尝痛苦的人们，给予他们庇护。
So devotees like just like somebody, just like a boat that comes to rescue somebody who's in drowning.So the devotees are like that person coming in the boat to save somebody who's drowning. The devotees save people from the ocean of material suffering.
就像有在海上有那救生船，在海上巡逻去营救那些在海中淹没在海洋当中的人。同样，奉献者就好比就像一艘船，来营救那些在物质存在当中的海洋当中快要被淹死的人们。
So just like everybody, we need food to maintain our life. So the same way, everybody needs to have some kind of shelter in distress.
就像一个强碌碌的人，他是需要食物来充饥；同样，一个在饱尝痛苦的人，他这样的人他是需要庇护所的。
And when people are dying and leaving this world, then it's good for them if they also have some religion.
同样，一个将死之人，他对他来说。
So the devotees, they're the best people to give shelter to people in a miserable condition of life.
同样的，奉献者对于那些饱尝物质生活的苦恼的人们来说是最好的庇护所。
With the help of the sun, we can see everything around us, but with the help of devotees, we can see with divine eyes.
就像太阳的出现会照亮周围的一切，所以奉献者的出现就给人们以神圣的视域。
So devotees are the real family, and they are the ones. They're actually our own self. They're not different from Krishna.
奉献者们跟没有区别。
Just like when we approach a fire, because there's some heat from the fire.We get relief from darkness, and we become, we're not so afraid of snakes and wild animals.
就像当一个人他来到火的跟前的时候，他就感受到热量，他的黑暗也都移除了，他再也不用害怕蛇类以及野兽。
In the same way, by being with a devotee, a pure Vaishnava, we don't have to be afraid of materialistic life.
同理，倘若一个人得到纯粹 Vaishnava 的联谊，他就再也不用担心物质生活的黑暗了。
And we don't have to worry about what's going to happen in the future.
而且他也不用担心未来会发生怎样的事情。
And we don't, And we don't have to worry about forgetting about all the ignorance of material life and all the fear of material life.
他再也不用担心物质生活产生的愚昧以及物质生活带来的恐惧恐慌。
So we can get the blessings of a Vaishnava by serving them even in separation.
那如何能得到Vaishnava的祝福呢？就是通过服务他们，甚至是在分离之情当中服务他们。
And the pure devotees who know the absolute truth, who understand the Lord in Vrindavan, they can deliver people caught in the wheel of birth and death.
生死之轮当中拯救出来。
Because the devotees have understood the glories of Krishna, so they can give this mercy to others.
明白主 Krishna 荣耀的奉献者能够把仁慈给予这样的人。
So this is the essence of all the Vedic teachings.
这是一切伟大教导的核心。Okay,
devotees are always peaceful and unagitated. They're not even worried about being liberated.
奉献者们内心平和，不受打扰。他们甚至不担心，他们甚至不去追求解脱。And
they can give fortunate people. They can give them spiritual vision.
他们可以给予幸运的人，给他们带来灵性的视域。And
with that spiritual vision, they can understand both the personal and the impersonal features of the absolute truth.
倘若一个人得到了灵性的视域，他就能够了解绝对真理的人格特征和非人格特征。And
they can understand different ways of practicing bhakti yoga.
他们也能够理解，修习奉爱瑜伽的种种方法。So
this is the mercy of devotees.
这就是奉献者的仁慈。But
the sun, the light of the sun, that gives light, and it's only in a very limited way. But by the help of devotees, we can see much more.
太阳的光芒只能给予人们有限的帮助，但是奉献者们的帮助，他们是以各种各样的方式来提供的。One
single devotee, a pure devotee, is equal to all the demigods combined together.
仅仅是一位纯粹的奉献者，就相当于所有半神人的总和。
So it's not possible to tell all the glories of a devotee, pure devotees.
所以不可能来详细的一一阐释一位纯粹奉献者的所有的荣耀。So
pure devotees, they are best friends. They are the source of, they give us life, they make our life, give some purpose to our life.
一位纯粹的奉献者是最好的朋友，他们给我们的生活带来了一线光芒。So
these pure devotees are not different from Krishna.
正因如此，这些纯粹的奉献者跟主 Krishna 毫无二致。So
in the Bhagavatam, Lord Krishna says to Uddhava, he says, Krishna told Uddhava, I'm going to tell you something very confidential, because you are my servant and my companion.
在圣典伯加瓦坛，主 Krishna 对乌达瓦说道：“因为你是我的仆人和我的同游，所以我要向你讲述机密的话题。”
So Krishna told Uddhava, by associating with my pure devotees, we can get free of all of our attachment for the material sense gratification.
就 Krishna 告诉 Uddhava， 与我的纯粹奉献者联谊，一个人就能放弃对物质感官享乐的依恋。
And that by getting purified by that association, I come under their control.
通过这样的方法受到净化之后，我就受到他们的控制了。
So somebody else, they may do Ashtanga Yoga, or they may do philosophical analysis of the elements of the material world.
有些的人他们修习Ashtanga Yoga八部瑜伽，还有些人对物质世界做出哲学分析。
And some other people, they may practice non-violence, or they may practice principles of piety or chant the Vedas.
还有的人他们修习非暴力，还有的人去遵守伟大的原则，或者是唱诵，chant the mantras，right？Yeah，chant Vedic mantras。Yeah。还有的人他们热衷于吟诵伟大曼陀罗。
Or they may do penances, or they may take to the renounced order of life.
或者是有的人从事忏悔，或者是接受生命的气绝阶段。
Or they may dig the ground to make wells, to get water, drinking water. Or they may plant trees, or perform other kinds of public welfare activities.
还有的人呢，他们就挖水井或者是种树等等，从事一些公益活动。
Or they may give charity or worship the demigods.
或者是他们是布施或以及崇拜半神们。
They may chant mantras and they may go to holy places.
他们也许会吟诵曼陀罗，或者是拜访圣地。
But even by performing all these activities, they don't bring Krishna under their control.
但是尽管他们从事这些活动，却无法将 Krishna 置于自己的控制之下。
Just like in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, he teaches the Ashtanga Yoga. So the first two parts of Patanjali Yoga, there's the Yam and the Niyam.
就像 Patanjali 他写了瑜伽经，在头两部分他介绍了 Yam 和 Niyam 规范。
Yama means the major rule, the major regulations, the important things you have to do. And the Niyam is the minor regulations, the smaller things which you have to do.
Yam 的意思是重要的原则规则，Niyam 的意思是次要的规则，次要原则。
So Krishna told all of these to Uddhava.
Krishna就告诉Uddhava就这些内容。
It's all in the Srimad Bhagavatam in the 11th canto, 19th chapter.
它记载在圣典薄伽瓦坛第十一篇，第十九章。
First is non-violence and then truthfulness.
首先是非暴力，接下来是真诚。
And then the third thing is one will not try to steal or take any other person's property.
接下来是一个人不当偷窃，或者是把别人的财产据为己有。
And then detachment and humility.
然后是气绝，谦卑。
And then one should not think himself to own anything. He shouldn't think anything belongs to him.
接下来是 不要认为自己有任何的拥有事物，他不要把任何事物就认为自己拥有他们属于自己。
And you should practice celibacy and be silent and be very steady.
他还要奉行真守，保持缄默，并且稳定。
And you should be willing to forgive others, and you should be fearless.
他一个人还应当宽恕，并且无惧无畏。
So these are the 12 primary rules which they have to practice.
这是他们需要修炼的12条主要原则。
And then next thing is internal cleanliness and external cleanliness.
其次就是内在的清洁和外在清洁。
And then chanting the holy names of the Lord.And austerity and sacrifice.
接下来是唱诵主的圣名，苦行献祭。
And one should have faith, and one should be very hospitable to others.
一个人还应当有信心，并且热爱款待客人。
And he should worship the Lord, and he should visit holy places, and act for the benefit, for the supreme cause.
一个人还应当崇拜主，拜访圣地，以及为了最高的事业而献身。
And he should be satisfied in whatever situation he is in, and he should do service for the Guru.
他应当在任何情况下都内心感到满足，他应当服务 Guru.
So these are the 12 items which are performed regularly.
这是一个人应当有规律的从事的活动。
So that's altogether 24 different rules which people have to follow, and if they follow these, then they get all benedictions.
这是一个人应当奉行的24条原则，倘若他这样遵守的话，就能得到所有的祝福。
So in the association of pure devotees,It means that we're not affected by material attachment. We will not have any material attachment.
倘若一个人得到纯粹奉献者的涟漪，他就不再有物质的依附了。
And in the association of pure devotees, we'll become more attached to Krishna and hearing about Krishna's pastimes, pastimes in Vaikuntha.And now we'll like to hear about Goloka, and we take pleasure in all this in the association of pure devotees.
倘若人得到纯粹奉献者的涟漪，他就进一步获得对 Krishna 的依恋。他喜欢聆听 Krishna 消时光，无论是在 Vaikuntha 也好，在 Goloka 也罢，他都能够快乐的与纯粹奉献者为伴。
So we may not be able to get direct contact with the pure devotees, but if we just hear what they said, if we're hearing about the words of these pure devotees, we'll get the greatest benefit.
我们可能无法得到这样纯粹奉献者的直接亲身涟漪，但是，倘若能够聆听他们的话语，也能得到最大的好处。
So this was said by Vidura in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. He said, persons, if somebody hears from a guru for a long time and makes a great effort to hear, then his character and activity, if he hears about the pure devotee's character and activities, then it will help him to get liberation.
在圣经伯加法坛第三篇当中，维朱尔说，倘若一个人努力的长期聆听咕噜，他能努力的去了解一位纯粹奉献者的性格和活动，他就能够得到解脱。
And Dhruva Maharaj says the same thing also in the fourth canto, Srimad Bhagavatam.
Dhruva Maharaj 在圣典伯加瓦坛第四篇当中也说了类似的话。
Dhruva Maharaj said, just by meditating on your lotus feet or hearing about your pure devotees, we get so much bliss.
Dhruva Maharaj 说，仅仅是冥想您的莲花足，或者是聆听您的纯粹奉献者的话语，一个人就能得到极乐。
And that pleasure which we get from it is far beyond the pleasure of Brahmanda, where we think ourselves one with the impersonal Brahman. It's the pleasure we're getting from the thinking of you.Is much greater than the pleasure of becoming one with you.
他说，一个人通过这样的方式，通过冥想的你记忆你得到的快乐，远远超越于高于一个人和非人格 Brahman 融合在一起得到的快乐，和 Brahmananda 从 Brahmananda 得到快乐。
There may be some happiness in going to the heavenly planets, but that's also finished in the course of time. And it doesn't equal the happiness of devotional service.
人去天堂也许会得到一点点快乐，但是这样的快乐是有始有终的，是无法跟奉爱服务相媲美。
So in contact with the pure devotee, success in life is guaranteed.
倘若人得到纯粹奉献者的莲仪，那么他的生命的成功就有保证了。
And even we may not get the direct company, but if we get the company of the devotee of his devotees, that can also give us perfection.
一个人可能甚至无法得到这位纯粹奉献者的陪伴和联谊，但是他们得到这个纯粹奉献者的联谊，他的生命里也能会达到完美。
So Dhruva Maharaj says, if a person happens to associate with someone whose heart wants to have the association of your devotees, then their heart will always want to. If a person wants to associate with someone If a person wants to associate with someone who wants to also have the lotus feet of the devotees, then that is also good association.
那么马尔说，倘若一个人他和这样的人联谊，什么样的人呢？就是这样的人，他内心想要得到奉献者莲花族的想要和奉献者的莲花族联谊。那么这样想和那样有那种愿望的人联谊也是好的。
Yeah, because these people, it's never attached to the material body, and he's not thinking about the body relationships, about the friends, or the money, or the home, or the wife.
因为这样的人，他们不依附躯体，也不会念念不忘这些躯体的关系。不会总是想着他们的朋友、钱财、家庭、妻子。
So if you get their association, then they can help us also to become perfect.
倘若人得到这样的人的怜悯，他们的生命也能达到完美。
So those who have got pure love for the lotus feet of Krishna, they do not identify themselves with the body.
倘若一个人拥有对 Krishna 莲花足的纯粹奉爱，他就不会认同于躯体。
So.In the words of Lord Vishnu's Hamsa avatar, described in the 11th canto, he describes Hamsa avatar, the swan incarnation. He says, just like a drunken man doesn't notice whether or not he's wearing his shirt or his coat.
主威在《释迦牟尼佛坛》第十一篇当中，主威士鲁的哈姆萨尔塔天鹅化身这样说道：“就像一个醉汉，他意识不到自己仍旧穿着外套或者衬衫。”
So somebody, in the same way, somebody who is perfect in self-realization and who has understood his spiritual identity, he doesn't notice the material body.Whether he's sitting or standing.
同样的方式，一位自我觉悟的灵魂，他明白了他灵性的身体，他就无论是坐着还是站着，他都意识不到自己的躯壳。
Yeah, sometimes by Krishna's arrangement, the body is finished.Or by Krishna's arrangement, he gets a new body, but the self-realized soul doesn't notice.
有时候，由于 Krishna 的安排，当这样一个人他的躯体完结的时候，或者是当他获得一具新的躯体的时候，他甚至都不会注意到、意识到这一点。
So he's compared to the drunk man.Who doesn't know whether he's wearing his clothes or not. And Lord Rishabhdev also describes the qualities of great devotees. He says, Mahatmas are always equipoised.
Rishabhdev.也描述一位伟大奉献者的品格，他说道，这样一位奉献者，他内心保持着平和。
They don't see any difference between one person and another.
他们看不见一个人和另一个人有什么区别。
They're very peaceful and they're always engaged in devotional service.
他们非常平和。始终从事着奉爱服务。
And they work for the benefit of others.
他们为其他人的好处在辛勤的工作。
Their only interest is to become Krishna conscious and to increase their love for Krishna.
他们唯一的兴趣就是 Krishna 知觉，他们只对 Krishna 的爱感兴趣。
They're not interested in anything not related to Krishna. So they're not interested in mixing with people who are in the bodily concept of life.
他们只对和 Krishna 有关的事情感兴趣，跟他无关的都不感兴趣。他们也不想跟那些有躯体化生命概念的人跟他们混合在一起。
And they're not even attached to their homes. Although they may be householders, they're not attached to their homes.
这样的人也许是居家之人，但他们根本不依恋自己的家。
And they're not attached to their families and their friends or their money. At the same time, they're not neglectful. they do their duty.
他们不会依恋自己的家庭、朋友、钱财，但是与此同时，他们也不会忽视自己的职责。
Their interest is just to have enough money to keep the body and soul together. That's the main thing. Then they're happy.
他们的兴趣就是只要有足够的钱能维系躯体和灵魂在一起，他们就已经很心满意足了。
So they're free from all disturbance, all attractions of maybe love and hate.They're equal towards friends and enemies. So because they have this peace of mind, this inner peace, so they don't get angry, and they think about being merciful, how to benefit others.
他们内心平和，正因为他们内心平和，他们不会有任何的愤怒。
Their aim in life is to become the friend of Krishna. So they don't have an interest to associate with people who are.Interested only in their material bodies, interested only in material life.
So they have to do with those who are just interested in their physical body, interested in their material life. They have no interest in such people.
So they use the devotee will only use.With the least energy required just to maintain their material body.
So, 奉献者呢，他们只花最少的时间和精力来维系物质躯体。
So, Krishna said, if somebody is always attached to me, always attached to Krishna.And they don't have desire for their own sense gratification, then they're really devotees.
To Krishna, 说朋友有人依附 Krishna, 有人依附 Krishna 的话，他们就对感官享乐没有兴趣了，失去了索然法味。
So these people, they get a special happiness in being with Krishna that cannot be known.To those people who are not detached from the material world.
这样的人，他们从与 Krishna 的联系当中获得特殊的快乐。那些没有依附物质生活的人们，他们是无法了解这样的人的。
The devotee is dedicated to the Supreme Lord, then he's a real.The real devotee must be dedicated to the service of Krishna.
真正的奉献者，他们是献身于对至尊主的服务，他们把自己献身于为 Krishna 做奉献。
And these devotees have special qualities which are recognized.
这样的奉献者拥有一些特殊的品质，可以辨认。
One is that they're not anxious to accumulate and to collect more material things.
一个品格就是他们并不渴望积累越来越多的物质事物。
They're not disturbed by, they don't suffer from attraction and repulsion. It's not like they want, they like It's not that they like one thing and they don't like another thing. They're equal.
还有一个就是他们不受打扰，他们不会被那些好物，他们不会尤其被某些事物吸引，或者尤其厌恶某些事物，他们也不会尤其爱好某些事物，或者不喜欢某些事物，他们总是平和的。
And they don't have any desire for their own enjoyment.
他们也对自己的享乐，他们也不渴望自身的享乐。
But they have an internal happiness which comes from their relationship with Krishna.
他们从自己和 Krishna 的关系当中获得一种内在的快乐喜乐。
So that happiness can only be known by these pure Vaishnavas.
只有这样纯粹的奉献者才对这样的快乐了解，这样的快乐。
Because Krishna is the servant of his own devotees, Krishna serves his own devotees, he's always eager to share with his devotees the love of devotion.
因为主 Krishna 他已经成为这样的奉献者的仆人，所以他很渴望和他们分享奉爱。
Krishna says he is under the control of his pure devotees.
Krishna 自己亲口说，他就处在这样纯粹奉献者的控制之下。
He said, "My pure devotees have no material desires, so I sit in the core of their heart."
他说我的纯粹奉献者没有物质的愿望，所以我坐在他们的心中。
And even if somebody's a devotee of my devotee, then he's very dear to me.
他说甚至是我的奉献者的奉献者我都极其喜爱。
So if somebody has very strong faith and he worships the Lord, then by that worship he developsthe attraction to become a he develops his attraction to Krishna and he becomes a great devotee.
倘若一个人有强烈的信心，倘若他崇拜主，通过崇拜主他就产生对 Krishna 的吸引，他就能够深深的被 Krishna 吸引了。
So faith should lead to attachment to Krishna and Krishna's service. This is the symptom of advancement in Krishna consciousness.
信心，就是对 Krishna 的依附，为 Krishna 服务，深深的依附于为 Krishna 服务，这是一个在 Krishna 知觉当中尤其高级的人物，他们的特征。
This is described by one of the nine Yogendras, the nine sons of Rishabdev. This is described by Havi.
This is Rishabdev's 九位儿子叫九位 Yogendra, 其中一位叫 Havi, 他说的话。
And he says that Krishna is so kind to the conditioned souls that if they just call upon him by chanting his name,even unintentionally or unwillingly, then still Krishna helps them to destroy all their sinful reactions.
他说到主 Krishna 对于受条件性的灵魂特别的仁慈，即便这样受条件性的灵魂，他是无意识的、不知不觉的念诵了圣名，或者是被迫呼唤出圣名。
So when a devotee who has actually taken shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, when he chants the holy name with pure love, then Krishna can never give up such a devotee.
那么脱离 Krishna 的莲花族的奉献者，在纯粹的怀着纯粹的奉爱。唱诵了主的圣名 ，Krishna 永远不会放弃这样的奉献者。
So you can see the difference that somebody chants, you know, unintentionally or unwillingly, they get the benefit, they destroy sinful reactions. But somebody chants with pure love, then Krishna gives so much more. So the most advanced devotees, they will worship the Lord in the form of Krishna. And the holy name of Krishna is not different from him. And when they chant also, even somebody chants without meaning to chant, unintentionally, it will get rid of all of their sins. And Krishna in his pastimes, he's taken away the danger of the threat of any of the demons such as Agasura. Krishna's already killed them and given them liberation. So Krishna's pure devotees in Vrindavan, they have bound Krishna in their hearts, and Krishna can never get away from them, he can never escape. So this describes about the most intimate devotees, how they relate with Krishna. Okay, so we will stop here.
Yes, Hare Krishna, 礼拜, Guru 和老师们, 请教 Guru 几个问题, 在 Krishna 之节中, 是否要训练, 把一切都与 Krishna 联系起来, 比如说, 我昨天在香下, 看到一条蛇, 是否把这个现象看成, Krishna 在培养我, 突破恐惧, 不要招惹, 和看不起任何生物呢? The first is from Shruti Rupa Devadasi. Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru and all teachers. There are several questions. The first is that should we connect everything with Krishna in Krishna consciousness? For example, yesterday I saw a snake in the countryside. Should I saw it as that Krishna is training me to get rid of the fearlessness and to disturb those any living entities and don't look down upon any living entities?
Well, there are exceptions to that rule. Generally, we don't look down on any living entities, but still, sometimes things like snakes and scorpions They said the sadhu, even a sadhu, is happy when they're killed. It's stated in Srimad Bhagavatam, Prahlad Maharaj said that his father was very envious of other people. So they said an envious person is even more dangerous than a snake. So when the snake is killed, the sadhu is happy. And so envious persons also, that we have to deal with them very carefully. You see, the snake is envious because the snake does not have any legs, but you have legs. So the snake is envious and he may bite you.
蛇类他们是嫉妒心很重，因为他们没有腿，而那个人类是有腿的，所以他们就去咬人类。
So you have to be very careful in dealing with snakes.
所以碰到蛇跟蛇打交道要非常小心。
And usually we have them killed.
通常情况下，我们会杀死蛇。
Because when they're killed, then they'll get a better body in the next. They're free from that karma. They'll get a better body in the next life.
蛇类他们被杀死的时候呢，他们的业报就消除了，他们会得到一具更好的躯体。 The next one.
Yes.
第二个问题，有新人问 ，Krishna 知觉是否需要训练我们打坐冥想，控制感官？如果坐下来或者在行走中唱诵圣名，是否是一种瑜伽冥想呢？ There are some newfie who raised the question that in Krishna consciousness, should we also train ourselves to sit down and meditate so that to control our senses. If we sit down or walking while chanting the holy name, is it also a kind of yoga meditation?
Yes, it is. Chanting the holy name is yoga meditation.
是的。 唱诵圣名是一种瑜伽冥想。
We don't simply sit down and observe silence. We don't practice silent meditation. We practice meditation on the sound vibration of the holy name. And we also meditate on hearing the pastimes of Krishna, just like when we hear people discuss Srimad Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita. That is also meditation.
人们，我们不应当，一个人不应当仅仅是坐在那里沉思默想。 他应当冥想是圣灵的印证，冥想 Krishna 的消时光，或者是讨论圣典国家冥想，讨论国家梵歌。The third one.
Yeah.
第三个问题，随着对 Krishna 之觉越来越深入了解，就越来越喜欢静下来独处学习，不喜欢与人交往，浪费时间。My guru， 这现象正常吗
？Yes， 这样正常。Yes， it's like.
Is it? A...
Go ahead.
Is it normal that as we advance in Krishna consciousness, Krishna consciousness, we like to study alone. We don't like to.Waste time to deal with others. Is it a normal phenomenon?
Yes.
是的，是正常的。The fourth one.
Yeah.
第四个，还有新人问，因为家人要吃肉，能不能用干净的锅烹饪素食供奉会师呢？如果每餐只有一两样简单的素食供奉会师呢，这算不算 prasad 呢？感恩。Also there are some new family who ask if our family members are still like want to eat meat, should we use clean pot to cook vegetarian food to offer to Krishna? And if we only offer one or two vegetarian food to our Krishna, is it prasadam?
Yes, but it's not very good to eat prasadam along with meat.
是的，但是，如果就是一边吃 prasadam 还一边吃肉，这不好。
Prasadam is very pure food, and usually we'll take it on its own without things like meat. If you mix the meat there, then the prasadam is no longer spiritual, becomes affected. It's not pleasing to Krishna to mix the prasadam with meat.We don't want to do that. So somehow, you have to be careful.
Prasadam 是非常纯净的食物。如果我们把prasadam 和肉食混合在一起吃，这个就不会令 Krishna 感到非常高兴，最好是独自的荣耀，单独的荣耀 prasadam， 因为 prasadam 是灵性的，倘若跟肉食混合在一起的话，它就会受到影响，所以要小心。Next one.
Yes.
下一个 ，OK， 下一个，我们来看一下 Rajendra Prabhu 的问题。顶拜亲爱的玛拉，顶拜您，奉献者的联谊如此重要，奉献的仁慈如此重要。问题：奉献者对待我的所有奉献行为都是仁慈的吗？都是在帮助我灵性进步吗？有的奉献者激励我，有的关怀，有的斥责，有的批评，有的赞美，这些都是 Krishna 安排，目的是净化我，向 Krishna 迈进吗？如果是的话，我会全面接受跪拜您。Obeisance to dear Maharaj, it's so important to get association with devotees, and it's their mercy is so important. The question is that is all behavior from devotees, all devotees' behavior merciful, for the intention of.Helping me to advance in Krishna consciousness. For example, some devotees, they will inspire me, some will take care of me, show caring for me. Some they will chastise me, some will criticize me, some will praise me. Is this all arrangement from Krishna to purify me, to walk towards Krishna? If it is, I will accept it wholeheartedly. Thank you and obeisance to you.
Yes, a devotee should think that this is all Krishna's arrangement.
是的，奉献者们应当这样想，这些全都是 Krishna 的安排。
If the devotee is criticizing us and showing some anger towards us, we should think this is Krishna's mercy.
如果一位奉献者批评我们，或者是对我们展示愤怒，我们应当想，这可是 Krishna 的仁慈。
The Krishna wants to take away my false ego to purify me.
Krishna 就想拿走我的净化我，拿走我的假自我。Krishna 想通过这种方式净化我。
And when the devotee is praised, when somebody praises you, then you think Krishna's just trying to encourage me.
倘若奉献者们他们赞美你的话，你那样想，这是 Krishna 主 Krishna 他在努力的鼓励你。
I don't deserve all of this praise. I don't deserve what Krishna's doing, but Krishna just wants to encourage me.
我虽然不配得到所有这些赞美，不会得到 Krishna 的这番行为举止，但是 Krishna 以这种方式，他在鼓励着我。
So devotees always see the arrangement of Krishna in everything.
所以一位奉献者，从万事万物当中都能看到是 Krishna 的手在安排着。
Yes. Even though the devotees may not be pure devotees.But still, devotee will see, will think this is Krishna behind everything.
即便是不是一位纯粹的奉献者说出的，这话语不是来自一位纯粹的奉献者，但是，奉献者们也会把一切都看成是 Krishna 的安排。
Okay.
Okay.And this one is from Yuna. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. If Krishna wants us to return to the spiritual world, then he is sorry for our foolishness. 下一个来自 Yuna. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的礼拜。倘若 Krishna 希望我们回到灵性世界，那么他是不是说会为我们的愚蠢感到难过呢？
Yes, yeah, Krishna is sorry that we're so stupid, we're so foolish to try to be in this material world.
是的， Krishna 会感到难过，为我们的愚蠢感到难过，因为我们还在努力的留在这个物质世界当中。
Therefore, Krishna makes many arrangements to try to bring us back.To the spiritual world.
正因为这个原因， Krishna 会做出种种安排，把我们带回到灵性世界。
He sends his pure devotees. Sometimes he will send pure devotees here to help us, to teach us.
有时候他会派遣纯粹的奉献者来到这里，给予我们教导。
And sometimes he will come himself and perform different pastimes just to attract us.
有时候他会亲自降临，上演种种的消时光，目的就是为了吸引我们。
And he came to speak the Bhagavad Gita.
主 Krishna 在主 Krishna 他曾经亲自降临来讲述佛家梵歌。
So Krishna cares about us, yes.He's very sorry to see us suffering in the material world.
So Krishna is, 真心实意的关心着我们。他 因为我们在物质世界受苦，他感到很难过。
Yes, next question.
好，那下一个问题。Yes, sorry, Mara.
Yeah, go ahead. 下一个问题。
好，下一个问题。下一个问题是 Tom, Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，作为初级奉献者，一方面我应该与纯粹的奉献者联谊，另一方面我应该如何与身边有很多物质愿望的奉献者联谊呢？ So Tom said Hare Krishna, he paid obeisance to your lotus feet, and he said that as a neophyte devotees, on the one hand I should try to associate with pure devotees, on the other hand he asked how can he deal with devotees around him who have many material desires, how to associate with this kind of devotees.
Yes, we have to associate with them, but you don't have to associate with their material desires. You have to associate with their spiritual nature and encourage their devotion.
是的，我们还是需要和这样的奉献者联谊的，但是我们不要和他们的物质愿望联谊，我们要和他们的灵性本性联谊，而且我们还要鼓励这样的奉献者。
We have to think how to, they want to increase their Krishna consciousness. Although they have material desires, they also have some attachment to Krishna. So you have to encourage their attachment to Krishna.
我们要帮助他们增强他们的 Krishna 知觉。虽然他们还有物质愿望，但是他们确实，他们还是依恋 Krishna 的，所以我们要鼓励他们对 Krishna 的依恋之情。
OK,
下一个问题还是来自阮真真传播的。经常得到教导说，不要随意批判、评判奉献者，甚至任何人。然而，经典提供了那么多的评判标准，例如有三种奉献者、非奉献者与奉献者的区别等等。这些知识如果不是为了评判，那是为了什么呢？不评判，至少还有辨别力吧。如此才能判断什么是最好的联谊等等。So Rajendra Prabhu said that, it is all, there are always some instructions said that we shouldn't judge any devotee, even any living entities freely. But there are so many judgment in, so many standard of judgment in its scriptures. For example, this scripture distinguish there are three kinds of devotees, and also there are the distinction between devotees and non-devotees, they are different, etc. So if this knowledge is not for the purpose of judgment, what's the purpose for, what's their purpose?
Well, in the beginning we have to know how to distinguish between these kinds of people. As we become more advanced, then it will not make a difference.
是这样的，一开始，我们还是要区别，这些人的。但是当我们进步了之后呢，我们就看不到有什么区别了。
Because the devotee is so fixed in Krishna consciousness that he's not going to be disturbed by other people who are impersonalists or who have material desires. Because he's so Krishna conscious, he will give Krishna consciousness to everyone.
这样的奉献者，他们是已经是稳稳当当的处在了 Krishna 之觉当中了，所以他们就不会受到轻易受到打扰，不会被那些非人格主义者啊，或者是有物质欲望的人们被他们打扰。他们只想把 Krishna 之觉给予别人，给予每个人 Krishna 之觉了。
But in the beginning, we don't have much Krishna consciousness to give anyone, so we have to be careful where we associate.
但是一开始的阶段，一开始时候我们自己没有多少 Krishna 知觉可以给予别人，所以呢我们要特别小心我们的联谊对象。He continued to say that if we don't make any judgment, at least there should be any power of discrimination.
Power of discrimination. We don't make any judgment. At least there should be the power of discrimination.
Yes. He asked if we. Yes. Then maybe you have answered this question.And he said that in this way we can judge what's the best association. So that's the whole core part of the whole question.
Yes.
So the next, Yes, Mara.
Yeah, so the power of the discrimination is there, but we said because it,He's so situated in Krishna consciousness, he only sees the good in people. He doesn't see any bad in them.
是需要有辨别力的，但是当一个人处在了文文当处在 Krishna 之觉当中的时候呢，他就只会看别人的优点，他不会看别人的缺点。
Just like the sun purifies everywhere, and the sun never gets affected.
就像太阳光芒万丈，它净化了四面八方，但它自己不会受到任何影响。
So the same way, the advanced devotees, they can go everywhere, they can be with everyone, they will not be affected.
同样的方式，一位进步的奉献者，他可以去每一个地方，他可以和任何人打交道，自己却不受到任何的影响。
But we see sometimes the devotee who is on the topmost level may come down to the second level for the sake of preaching, because when one preaches, then you have to make distinction, you have to distinguish between people.
有时候我们看到处在最高层面的奉献者，他会把自己降到第二个层面，目的是为了传教。因为为了传教的目的，你必须去区分，必须有这种辨别。
We have to distinguish who are the innocent and who are the offensive.
我们必须要区别谁是一个无辜的天真无辜的人，谁又是哪些人呢？又是冒犯者。
So that distinction, to make distinction, that's on the intermediate level for preaching.
所以做出这样的区分，是处在中间的层面上，目的是为了传教，他就做出这样的区分。
Right. There's a pastime. Srila Prabhupada was preaching in one city in India, and he was teaching, and he was talking about materialistic people, and Prabhupada was calling them rascals and cheaters and like this, and he was criticizing a lot of materialistic habits. So one man got very upset, and he said, you know, you should be equal to everyone. You should see everyone equally.But Prabhupada said, I am not on that level.
有一个例子，就是当圣帕帕德去在印度传教的时候呢，他在一个地方他就说了很多无赖那个骗子就这样的混账这样的词，然后呢有一个物质主义者，然后就批评了很多就是物质主义的习性，然后有一个人他就说，哎，你不应当这样说，你应当以平等的视域看待一切。然后圣帕帕德就回答这个人说，我还没在那个层面上，我不处在那个层面上。
Yeah, Prabhupada said, I have to make distinction.
Prabhupada 就说，我必须做出区别，区分。
So later on, the devotees were speaking to this man, and they told this man how Prabhupada was preaching the Bhagavad Gita all over the world. So when the man heard this, he said, oh, this is very good. This is really seeing without discrimination, to give everyone the chance to hear the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita.
后来呢，那个事后呢，圣帕帕德的门徒就对这位男子就给他讲述了圣帕帕德怎样在全世界传播国家梵歌，然后这位男子听了以后就说，哦，那可太好了，这才是真正的就是不做区分，没有真正这才是一个真正的没有这种分辨的去传播的，这样一个人才是真正的这样平等的视域吧，因为他让每个人都有机会能够聆听到佛家梵歌。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于李佳莹。李佳莹说，顶拜咕噜，感谢您，想问一下应该给予什么样的神圣名啊，我们都是被蒙蔽的，无从判断，给不好的，万一对方对圣名冒犯，不是又麻烦了呢？ So this devotee paid obeisances to you. She asked that we should give the holy name to what kind of people? If because we are so covered up, so we don't know who should we give the holy name? Because if the situation is not so proper, and the others make offenses to the holy name, it will make trouble.
Well, we can give the holy name. We can chant the holy name to everyone.
We can give the holy name to anyone.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
我们可以把圣名给予所有的任何一个人，我们可以对他们唱诵圣名。
We don't know who will accept the holy name, but we give everyone the chance.
因为我们不知道谁会接受圣名，所以我们给每个人这个机会，我们是机会均等。
Just like Narada Muni, he's going everywhere chanting the holy name.And he gives the holy name wherever he goes.
就像 Narada Muni, 他所到之处他都会在唱诵着圣名，所以他是到处在派发着圣名的。
By the mercy of Narada Muni, many materialistic people became devotees.
正是由于 Narada Muni 的这份仁慈呢，很多物质主义者都转变成了奉献者了。
So we give the holy name, we shouldn't discriminate. We don't make distinction who's qualified and who's unqualified. We give everyone the chance to chant the holy name.
So when we are preparing the holy name, we don't differentiate this person has the right, that person has not the right. No, we give every person the opportunity to chant the holy name.
So chanting the holy name is, we have to chant ourselves And we don't mind who hears the holy name. Everywhere we chant to every living entity, even to the trees, even to the snakes and the monkeys.
我们自己不但自己唱诵圣名，而且我们不去区分这个人能够接受，那个生物不能接受。我们所到之处，我们都会传播圣名。我们甚至，就是即便是树木、蛇类或者是猴子，他们都可以接受到圣名。
Yeah.
下一个是来自于Panchatattva Prabhu。 顶拜 Maharaj 和所有奉献者，穆智坤达服务半神得到了祝福，他是奉献者，还要服务半人吗？So Panchatattva Prabhu pay obeisance to you and all devotees. He said, Muchkunda Maharaj got benediction because he served the demigods. Because he is already a devotee, why did he serve demigods?
Well, the demigods were fighting the demons, and the demigods are devotees. So he went to help the devotees against the demons. Just like, you know, if a devotee is being attacked, then we should want to go and help that devotee.
因为半神人们是奉献者，然后半神人们在跟恶魔作战，所以穆智坤德王就想帮助，身为奉献者的半神人来与恶魔作战。这就好像，倘若你看见一个奉献者受到人身攻击，那你就会冲上去来帮助这个奉献者。Yeah,
he didn't go there to worship the demigods. He just went to help them.
这穆智坤德王并没有过去崇拜半人，他只是给他们助他们一臂之力。So
there's no harm to do that because the demigods are engaged in service to Krishna. They're helping Krishna to maintain the order in the universe.
所以穆智坤德王他帮助他们是没坏处的，因为半神人们他们的职责就是维系宇宙的秩序，所以半神人们他们从事的是对 Krishna 也在为 Krishna 做着服务。Okay. The next one is from S. 顶拜 Guru. 所有奉献者，请问，都督丹狂妄自大，既贪婪嫉妒，但他又是政治家、军事家，对朋友也照顾，怎么看待这样的人呢？感恩Guru. This devotee paid obeisance to you and all devotees. He asked, about Duryodhan, who is very proud and very envious. And at the same time, Duryodhan is a politician and a military man, and also caring for his friends. So how to see this kind of people? Thank you.
Yes. Yeah, Duryodhan has some good qualities. We don't deny that. But he's against Krishna. He was against the Pandavas. He was opposed to the devotees.
是的，杜优丹他也有一些好品质，这一点呢我们不否认，但是杜优丹呢，他反对 Krishna， 他也反对 Pandava， 而 Pandava 呢是主 Krishna 的奉献者。You can find
good in everyone, but you have to also look at their other side. You have to see also their bad qualities.
然呢，我们可以从每个人身上找优点，但是呢，我们还要看到他的背面，还要看到他的坏品质。
Just because someone has some good, you cannot, it doesn't mean that they can do all bad, they can do all the bad things. There you don't have a lot of bad qualities. You're only speaking about some of his good quality, about his good qualities. What about all of his bad qualities?
就是比如说一个好人，一个人倘若他是好人，不等于他就可以去做坏事儿，因为他做的坏事就会有很多的坏的品质。同样的呢，你不能光看他的好品质，你还得看到他的所有那些恶劣的品质。
Yeah, we know Duryodhana was doing a good job. He was a good ruler. He was doing quite well as a king. But he didn't want to give any land. He didn't want to give anything to the Pandavas.
确实 Duryodhana 他作为一个统治者，他作为国王，他的工作干得不错，干得很漂亮。但是呢，他却不想给予潘的五兄弟一寸土地都不想给他们。
And look at all of his offenses in dealing with the Pandavas and Draupadi, and they're pure devotees. He was very offensive to them.
你就看看他，就是他对于潘的吧五兄弟和周伯弟所做的那些冒犯吧，而潘度五兄弟和周伯弟都是纯粹的奉献者。他对他们做出了种种的冒犯。
So Krishna can tolerate offenses against himself, but he cannot tolerate offenses against his devotees.
Krishna 他是可以容忍对他本人对他自己的冒犯，但是 Krishna 绝不容忍对他奉献者的任何冒犯。
And that's why Duryodhana was killed.
就因为独有胆他做了这样的事儿，所以他就遭到了杀身之祸。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于，仍然是对的，来自 S， 对特瓦斯特也熟读经典，遵守宗教原则，治理国家，但却陷害潘的吧？怎样评价？这个人呢，再次顶麦古鲁莲花组。So this devotee continue to ask about Dhritarashtra, who is very who read scriptures and follow the religious principle and who govern the country, but Dhritarashtra has done many harm to the Pandavas. So how to make judgment to Dhritarashtra? So.
So, Dhritarashtra, he got the mercy of a devotee, Vidura. Vidura was his brother, and Vidura came to him, and he came to preach to him, to save him from dying a horrible death in living in the home of the Pandavas.
因为 Dhritarashtra 他得到了一位奉献者 Vidura 的仁慈， Vidura 是他的弟弟， Vidura 呢就 来给他传教，来救了他，这样 Dhritarashtra 呢他就避免了就是一种可怕的死亡，他没有死在潘努兄弟的家中。
Dhritarashtra was living just like a dog.In the home of the Pandavas, eating their food. All of his sons had been killed, and Dhritarashtra was still living with the people who had killed all of his sons. So Vidura preached to Dhritarashtra and got him to leave home, and Dhritarashtra went to the forest and he did some meditation and he gave up his body in the forest. He didn't go back to Godhead, but I think he got impersonal liberation.
就是 Dhritarashtra 呢，他就像条狗一样活在潘度五子的家中，然后他吃着他们提供的食物，而他自己的100个儿子都被他们杀死了。后来呢，Dhritarashtra 呢，他就接受了传教之后，他就离开了家，毅然决然的去了森林去冥想，最后他是死在森林里。他自己并没有回归神手，他的归宿是非人格的解脱。
So he got the mercy of a devotee. That's the point.
所以这个区别就是，他是得到了一位奉献者的仁慈。
下一个问题。
可以。下一个问题来自于 A。顶拜古鲁莲花族，顶拜您。首先，今天由于我姑哦 ，Amy， this from Amy， 我由于疏忽让姑等很久，请姑原谅。另外，上周派书给一位教古文的大学老师，他说他姑我去研究印度文学文化，知道《国家梵歌》，没看过。这周他说修习佛教几十年，转变成 Krishna 之觉。那都白修了，怎么解释呢 ？OK， 好、，Amy pay obeisance to you and she beg forgiveness for following you because of her because she made you to wait for so long a time. She said last week she distributed one book to a college teacher who taughtancient Chinese and this teacher have studied has studied Indian culture and Indian literature and knew Bhagavad Gita but never read Bhagavad Gita. She said that she had practiced Buddhism forso many years, dozens of years, 20 to 30 years. So if she practices Krishna consciousness, then it will, her practice, former Buddhist practice will be a waste of time or be, it will be useless. So how can I explain to her?
You can explain to her that her Buddhist practice can be a foundation to her developing spiritual consciousness.
那您可以对她解释说，就是她以前的修佛，对于她发展灵性的知觉，打下了一个很好的基础。
Many of the main principles of Buddhism are in Krishna consciousness, but within Krishna consciousness, you will get much more.
许多佛教的这个原则，在也在 Krishna 知觉当中，但是 Krishna 知觉呢，可以给他提供更多的内容。
The important point is.She has to understand that the Buddhism was an emergency situation. It was not an eternal religion.
要点就是要明白这个佛教的出现呢，它是一种紧急在紧急情况下出现的佛教。这个佛教它不是一门永恒的宗教。
Yeah, there was an emergency. The Brahmanas had become corrupted and they were encouraging people and killing all the animals and so on. So Lord Buddha came to lead people away from the killing of animals.
这个佛，当时呢，是 就是 Brahmana 那些 Brahmana 们，他们已经腐化变质了，然后他们鼓励人们大肆屠杀动物，所以佛陀就在这种背景之下，佛祖就显现了，他是带领人们离开那些对动物的大肆屠杀。
And these people were atheists. They could not understand God. So Buddha,
这些人呢，他们
So Buddha didn't teach them about God.
哦，因为这些人他们全部都是无神论者，他们没办法理解神，所以就是佛呢，他并没有给他们宣说有关于神的讯息。
But Buddha, the Buddha, one Buddha anyway, at least the Buddha we follow, he was an incarnate, he was God.
我们追随的这位佛，他自身是神的化身之一。
So by following him, they got perfection.
通过追随人们推随这样的追随他这位佛，他们会得到完美。
And we also, you can explain, generally people who practice Buddhism, their goal is to become the Buddha. They want to become one with the Buddha. They want that oneness. They think they can become the Buddha. But we're teaching that we never become the Buddha.But we should be the servant of the Buddha.
一般来说呢，就是，修佛的人，他们的目标就是成佛，他们就最终呢，他们会和佛，合为一体，合二为一了。但是我们教导的是，你永远不能成佛，不会成佛的，你应该成为佛的仆人。
So to be the servant is more important than to be the Buddha.
所以作为仆人是更比成佛更重要的一件事。
So you can discuss these points to her.
那你就可以跟她讨论这些内容。
If she's studying something which is not perfect, then why should she waste her time? Just because she's been studying it for 20 odd years, and if it's not right, then why should she keep studying it? If she gets something better, she should recognize something is better there and give up the other thing.
如果她只前学习的是不完美的一门哲学的话，那么他就是在浪费时间。如果他好几十年他都在研习的是一个不对的内容的话，那么他应该意识到他现在可以学习更多的内容，他可以认识到他可以放弃以前那些不对的内容。
We have many other people who also practice Buddhism for many years, and they've come to Krishna consciousness.
有很多奉献者，有一些我们有一些奉献者，他们以前也是修佛修了好几十年，但最终呢，他们终于来到了 Krishna 知觉当中了。
And your practice as a Buddhist helps you to control the mind and to control the senses.So it's very good in Krishna consciousness.
人以前修佛呢，帮助他控制心意、心念，也帮助他控制了感官。所以这对于他进入 Krishna 知觉是很好的。
And Buddhists also understand the nature of the material world to be suffering, and we also agree with that. That's very good.
佛教呢，他们意识到这个物质世界的受苦的本性，所以呢， 我们也接受这一点，他们这么去接受是非常好的，他们能认识到这一点。
So, have her read the Bhagavad Gita and see if she's interested. Try to get her, and track, but the important thing is also chanting, get her to chant.
那您就可以帮助她来阅读《薄伽梵歌》，然后呢，看一下她对于《薄伽梵歌》感不感兴趣，还要帮助她开始念诵。
Yes. Okay.
Panditabha says thank you, Maharaj, for your mercy, Hare Krishna. Next is Chaitanya Rupa.
Yes.
Amy said that 因为上传的原因，我们现在可以结束，还有一个问题放到下一次可以吗？
没问题，我们有时间。啊，好吧。继续。啊，下一来自于
Chaitanya Rupa Devadasi， 顶拜Guru，奉献者，崇拜张 Ganesh Hanuman， 是为了通过这两位奉献者的仁慈得到主 Krishna 的仁慈，可以吗？对于 Ganesh Hanuman。 与崇拜使徒传习中的Guru有不同吗？ Chaitanya Rupa Devadasi paid obeisance to Guru and all devotees, and she asked, is it okay that we worship Ganesh and Hanuman, these two devotees, and through them, through their mercy, then we get the mercy of Lord Krishna. So she asked, is it okay that we worship this?
No.
不行。
We don't want to encourage that. You just worship Krishna, you get everything. All the demigods are included within Krishna.
我们可不想鼓励这样的崇拜。 你崇拜 Krishna， 就是因为 Krishna 包含了所有的半身，所以就崇拜 Krishna。
One devotee, one time, he wanted to worship Ganesh. Prabhupada said, "Oh, you can do it. You have to give me every month $100,000."
有一个奉献者，他曾经想崇拜 Ganesh， 然后他就帕帕德就对他说，你可以崇拜，除非你每个月给我$100,000。
So Prabhupada didn't encourage this, because the problem is people don't understand that Krishna is the supreme, and they think all the gods are the same.
So Prabhupada didn't encourage, because the problem is people don't understand that Krishna is the supreme, and they think all the gods are the same. So Prabhupada didn't encourage, because the problem is people don't understand that
Just like you want to worship Ganesh, so it's described in the Bhagavad, in the Brahma Samhita, Lord Brahma prays, and he describes that Ganesh gets the power to destroy obstacles by holding the lotus feet of Govinda. So you should worship Govinda.
In Brahma Samhita, Ganesh 他抓住狗文的莲花族，所以他获得力量，能够摧毁一切障碍。所以呢，人应当崇拜狗文的。So
you want to destroy obstacles? You worship Lord Nrisingadev. Lord Nrisingadev can also protect you and destroy obstacles.
如果你想去除障碍的话，可以崇拜主Nrisingadev。
We don't want to encourage you to worship demigods.
We don't want to encourage you to worship demigods. 半神人。
And some people, they worship Lakshmi, they want to get money, they worship Lakshmi. But Lakshmi is the consort of Lord Narayan. Lakshmi is always restless, very difficult to keep her in one place. But if you worship Lord Narayan, she's always with her husband.
有些人呢，崇拜 Lakshmi, 信于 Lakshmi 来获得钱财，但是呢 ，Lakshmi 是主 Narayan 的伴侣，而且 Lakshmi 她是躁动不安的，很难停留在一个地方。但是你人应当崇拜她的丈夫。
Yes, how are you waiting?
So the host said that the host asked the devotee to raise the question as far as this, those five questions and keep the question next time to raise.
How many more questions do you have?
Two.
Only two questions. Well, we could take two questions, I think.
Okay. 来自智敏明白 Guru, 等等你那些不知道 Krishna 没准备好的人修习非人格全能冒犯呢非人格也有解脱这种解脱是终极的是一种融入泛光的解脱失去灵性个体的解脱吗智敏 paid obeisance to you and said that for those who are not ready to, who don't know Krishna, is it an offense for them to practice impersonalism?
It's not going to help them become a devotee.
他们修习非人格不能帮助他们最终成为不能帮助他们做奉献者，成为奉献者。
Lord Chaitanya said, "Mayavadi aparadi." If they're Mayavadis, then they're offenders.
主宰殿殿就说 ，Mayavadi aparadi， 就是如果他们是假象宗主义者，他们是冒犯者。
If they deny the form of Krishna, then that's an offense.If they say that Krishna's form is material, that's an offense.
他们倘若否认 Krishna 的形象，他们就做了冒犯。他们若认为 Krishna 的形象是物质的，他们也是做了冒犯。
So it's very easy to become offensive when they go to the impersonalist path.
所以，如果他们踏上非人格的道路的话，很容易就会做出冒犯。
Shai Gawanti?
Yes, she said that there are liberation in impersonalism. Is this in liberation the ultimate stage?
That liberation is not the ultimate stage. Impersonal liberation is not the ultimate stage.If they go to that impersonalism, they will not remain there. After some time, they will again fall back to the material world.
这种非人格的解脱不是终极的。他们如果达到了上升到非人格解脱，他们还会再次堕落到物质世界。
Yes, keep going.
Yes, she continued to ask that it is liberation that is merging into the Brahmajyoti, is it a liberation that is merging into the Brahmajyoti?
Yes.
And, 是的 lose their individuality, spiritual individuality.
Well, we keep our individuality because our individuality is eternal, but there's the feeling of merging, the feeling of oneness.
Oh, 这种这种那个就是他的灵性他到融入梵光之后他的灵性个体性他是不会失去的但是他有一种感受 他感觉到自己好像是失去了灵性的个体性。
Yeah. 最后一部分。
The next question.
Yeah.
Kanya Rupa. So that's all for this question. For the last question. And there's one more question. Okay. Oh, there are two more questions raised. So, are you going to answer them all?
Is one from Chaitanya Rupa?
Yes, and yes.
Who's the
Chaitanya
other?
Rupa said, because what? Now suddenly there are two more questions raised.
Okay.
Okay. 那我们快点看，以奉献者有的在神坛上摆了 Ganesh、Hanuman 的立体神像，说是 Krishna 的护法，可以吗？ Some devotee they put Ganesh and Hanuman the stack the details of Hanuman and Ganesh, and they say that they are protecting Krishna, protector of Krishna. So is that okay?
No.
不行，不能这样做。
Krishna is protecting them.
相反，就是 Krishna 在保护着他们。
Krishna isn't giving them power.
他们的力量源于 Krishna.
Okay, next question.
Okay, so this may be from new devotee, Hua Yu, Dimakuru, 在网上看到，无意间看到人自杀杀人，内心不平静。请问是他们的业报一定要遭此一劫吗？怎样祈祷为他们 ？So this new devotee said that this guru and sometimes I saw some information on the internet that someone they commit suicide and also someone who kill others, and each time I feel very disturbed and my mind is not peaceful. So she asked, is this their karma? So they must endure this suffering. So how to pray for this unfortunate soul?
How to help this unfortunate soul?
So, yes, first she asked that...
Is it their karma?
So, yes. And also how to pray pray for these unfortunate souls.
Well,
pray for them.
First of all, karma puts you in a situation, but it's not karma which forces you to act. We act through our own ignorance, through our own independent will.
Karma put one in a situation, but
it's not the
karma
cause,
don't...
Yeah, it's not the cause of action. We cannot say, oh, somebody's a murderer, is their karma. That's not true.
Okay. 是这样的，就是业报，使人处，是业报把一个人就放在一个特定的处境下，但是一个人采取什么样的活动，这个不是他的业报，他还是有自由意志来选择他采取什么样的活动。
So.We cannot blame karma, but it's the misuse of our independence. Krishna gives us a little bit independence, and when we misuse the independence, that's what happens.
We cannot blame karma, but it's the misuse of our
independence.
Krishna gives us a little bit independence, and when we misuse the independence, that's what happens.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
And how should we pray for them? Chant Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
Just
你可以唱诵 Hare Krishna 为他们祈祷。
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.哎，丹尼尔，如果还说不能单独在家里崇拜主，你是怕说不小心冒犯了，会家庭不和睦，是这样吗？陈丹尼尔如果 said that there is a saying that we cannot worship Lord Krishna Dev, we cannot only worship Lord Krishna Dev in our home because if we make offenses, there will be disharmony.It will destroy harmony, the atmosphere of harmony in our family relationship. So she asked, is it true?
You should have worship of Gornitai. Just worship Gornitai. Don't try to worship all these, don't try to worship Lord Nrsingadev.
Guru said,你应当崇拜 Gornitai, 就崇拜 Gornitai 就好了。不要去 she should not worship Nrsingha Dev, right?
Right.
Okay, 那就是你不要去崇拜 Nrsingha Dev, 就崇拜 Gornitai.
You're not even second initiated yet, I don't think.
那姑说你可能你现在还没有得到二次启迪呢吧。
And your husband's not initiated yet.
Oh, 然后你的丈夫，您的丈夫，还没有得到启迪。
So you shouldn't be trying to do deity worship. You should just do simple worship of photographs.
那你就不要去崇拜神像，你就心满意足的崇拜照片就好了。
And you can have Lord Nrsingadev's picture on your altar, but that's not worship of Lord Nrsingadev. We just keep Lord Nrsingadev's picture on the altar and we sing Namaste Narasingaya, we sing the prayer to Lord Nrsingadev, and that way we'll get protection of Lord Nrsingadev.
然后你可以在神坛上就摆放主 Nrsingadev 的照片，摆放照片。不等于崇拜主女神的，然后呢，您就是唱诵 Namaste Narasimhaya 这样的祷文，然后就能得到主女神阿德的保护。
Yes. Okay. All right. Finished.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Well, we got you a good one. Huh?
Yes. Amy said some.Final words.
Okay, Vaman Ganshi, Ame Ganshi, Guru Mani Ganshi, Soda Function, Zilinti, Ganshi Nimadwenti, Jufu Niman, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Gorbak Chavrinda Ki
Jai,
Haribo.